lab in Ottawa today, and we're going to be showing some of our latest test chips featuring LPDDR5X technology operating up to 8533 megabits per second. It's a little bit noisy in here with all the equipment running. You can't turn the equipment off, so we're going to switch to a voiceover for the rest of the demo.
This is our evaluation board for our test chips with our Synopsys LPDDR5X/5/4X IP on board. Manufactured in a modern FinFET technology, our test chip was designed to operate up to 8533 megabits per second. The test chip is located in the central socket, which allows us to swap out test chips of various processing corners. The LPDDR5X SDRAM is located in the socket off to the left, which allows us to switch out the DRAMs from different memory vendors. The large area between the sockets is a keepout zone required by our temperature forcing equipment seen on the board on the right. That equipment drives very accurate junction temperatures on the test chips from plus 125 degrees Celsius to minus 50 degrees Celsius. First, we will show how the system trains at boot time. We will run the firmware-based training, and the results are then available for inspection. Using our GUI, we can inspect the various register contents to learn how the training set the various registers to optimize the data eyes and strobe locations for the most complex traffic patterns. Now we will see the results of our diagnostics firmware that can inspect every bit of the fully trained 32-bit channel. Here we will see the 8533 megabits per second read data eyes followed by write data eyes per bit of the 32-bit channel as measured at the input receivers of the PHY and DRAM respectively, using a PRBS traffic pattern to simulate the worst case inter-symbol interference, synchronously switching output, and crosstalk effects. The firmware takes a minute to run, so we'll jump to the end, where now we will see the measured read data I per bit in our PHY. Here's an image of that same diagnostics result, followed by a write data I image showing the data I as measured in the DRAMs. And now we can see the improvement of that same data I when we enable decision feedback equalization. Our silicon validation engineer, Evan, we'll now show an oscilloscope data eye of the test chip operating at 533 megabits per second. The eye you see here is a single bit stimulated with a PRBS 23 pattern with hundreds of thousands of samples. Now let's have some fun. We will change the core voltage of our PHY from minimum to maximum over 5 seconds and watch as the strobe stays perfectly centered in the eye, which barely changes. The eye gets a bit larger at the top as the core voltage drives the I/O devices a bit harder and reduces their impedance. This shows how well the PHY compensates for changes in voltage and temperature in real time. To help us set up a long suite of tests we can run without supervision, we also have a handler in our lab, which is used in conjunction with our ATE to perform a variety of tests, such as loopback tests, delay line linearity, PLL tests, etc. Here you can see a portion of the test results captured for that specific test chip. I'd also like to show our viewers our board farm we have at Synopsys, supporting the dozens of different test chips for different product families and process technologies. Here you can see a wide variety of DDR and LPDDR test boards accessible by our engineers all over the world. These are used by our firmware developers and support engineers to help assist customers.
I just wanted to end the video with our IP operating at 9600 megabits per second. That's the future of LPDDR5X. We've overclocked our test chips and the DRAMs and everything's working great. So please contact Synopsys for more information on our memory interface IP products. Thanks for watching.